After completing the annotation process, it's essential to export your dataset for future use. In this video, we'll discuss dataset export formats and related procedures in CVAT AI. Before you begin annotating, consider two key points: the format your machine learning model requires, the labeling tool you'll use. Let's dive into a straightforward example. Say you have a dataset ready for annotation. The next step is to choose the types of annotations to use, be it rectangles, masks, polygons, and so on. This decision is crucial because different training frameworks may require specific annotation formats, and each format may only support particular annotation types. CVAT AI supports many export formats. If you need a specific format required by a framework, or you're determining the best format for your annotations, then read on. Here is a list of popular formats by task and use case. Your first step is to check out the documentation, link in the video description. It provides a list of formats you'll find in the interface. For example, if you need data in YOLO format, simply click on it to see which CVAT AI annotation types are supported. It supports rectangles, also known as bounding boxes. You can also see the data structure post-import. Once you know the annotation type format supports, you can return to your dataset and begin annotating. Annotation is now done, so let's export the dataset in YOLO format and check the results. View training and object data. For image export, opt for the paid plan. Note that this format doesn't support attributes. You can export annotation done by the mixed tools, bounding boxes for signs and skeletons for pedestrians, for instance. Consult the documentation to find a format supporting multiple annotation types. The universal CVAT format is a good option for this. Return to the task and export the dataset in CVAT format, which also supports attributes. Since we're discussing attributes, let's explore how to configure them for specific export formats. Take Mo export, for example. The documentation shows it supports attributes as follows. Let's add these attributes to the labels and see how they appear in the exported file. We added 0.5 to visibility and selected ignored, clicked export and opened the downloaded file. You can see the added attribute at the end of the line. Now, let's discuss video export formats in CVAT. The platform offers two types of formats, those that support tracks and those that don't. We've annotated a short video using tracks. Let's see how to export it. Let's begin with the universal format that supports tracks, CVAT. Here's what the export will yield. Tracks are included in the CVAT export, as you can see. Now let's try exporting in the COCO format, which doesn't natively support tracks. Here's the outcome. The data is exported and tracks are saved as separate shapes, track IDs are exported too, but the annotations won't be imported as tracks, as this format doesn't suppose this kind of import. Now you can use your dataset with your ML model. Like, subscribe, share. Happy annotating.